Greetings, my good folk. It's Sure Shot, Mr. Sure Shot, here to do more FIA. Hopefully I can find my brethren after he flew down the cliff and after we learn some burn linguistics. And in this episode, you know, hopefully we can catch up with him. And we have another one of these gates. Gotta break it down with the fruit things. I don't know what to call them. I'm gonna get another crystal. By the way, I think this is important to point out. I want to keep these videos relatively short. The last two episodes were kind of exceptions. They were like 30 to 35 minutes long. But again, those are exceptions because I technically played through them before. I've said I wanted to get a good feel of the game before recording, which, I mean, for a blind walkthrough, it would be better to play the game with low expectations, but maybe that's something I'll keep in mind for a future project. But it is best to keep experiences of the game low. But from this point out, I'm pretty much blind and won't know what to expect from here on out. Videos will most likely be, say, like 20 to 25 minutes, or at least that's what I'm aiming for. But anyway, after that little ramble. And whoa, something just happened. I just heard a rumbling. Okay, I guess it was nothing. But yeah, it was just, I kind of want to just play through this game, you know, with kind of like little expectations so I can experience the wondrous that is this game's beauty. And well, I guess I had to go in the middle. Yep. But trying to keep the expectations low, so I get more surprised when I see the wondrous nature of this game. But enough of that weird rambling of mine. Ooh, another crystal. Yeah, sorry if I'm talking a little weird in this video, because I just got back from classes and now I am pretty tired, so that's one of the reasons that my speech patterns are a little bit just wonky. But anyway, as you saw there, I got a holograph, and I'm assuming, based on what we saw from my brethren, yep, I have the ability to fly, and that was a really bad leap, but, you know, that's pretty much the point. I can, well, not really fly, but more like glide. I can now glide and, oh, yeah, there we go. Now I can glide at, come on. Yay, look at that. I can, okay, let me get to a high plateau. Look, now I can glide. Yay, okay, cool. And, ooh, are you Bumby's dad? Bumby's dad! Okay, we gotta follow Bumby's dad, I'm assuming, because he kind of ran away from my, ooh, whoa. That was weird. Let's see. Get over here. Come up here. Oh, jeez. Okay, cool. Also, from the last episode, I referenced Zubumafu, how I thought that this lemur creature looked exactly like him. Well, kind of. One thing I really do appreciate, well, not really appreciate, but one thing I really enjoy about that show is the theme song, because even though, you know, that show is pretty dated, one of the things I did love about the show was its theme song. It was like, Zubumafu and the Crack Brothers, and I'll remember the lyrics, but I remember the chorus a bit. And Zubumafu coming na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na. Like, it was one of those few TV shows, or one of those few kid shows when I was little, that actually had a pretty badass theme song. You guys should probably check it out. And oh geez, we have one of these rocks. That reminds me of a, well, it's not really similar, but another good show. And oh god, close up. Another good show that had another good theme song when I was widow was Out of the Box. But anyway, enough of that. And oh boy, we're back here with these robots, the roly polies. And let's see. Okay, we're just following them. Oh boy. And oh, okay, it looks like they got someone. Let's see. Who is it? Oop. I can't tell. Are we supposed to crawl? I don't think I have the power to crawl. Are they running away from something? No? Okay. Okay. Just keep on walking. It looks like they got something. We got... Bumby! Guys, can we leave Bumby alone, please? Please? Bumby? No! No, Bumby! No! This game just hates Bumby. Oh, Bumby, I'm so sorry. Oh, come... Why does this game must torture Bumby some more? What did it do to deserve this? Well, looks like we're gonna find out because we're following it. Its dad. Its dad. Its pappy. And, oh, hello. Hello. Man, that thing is beautiful. Like, that reminds me of the deer from, what was it? Hayao Miyazaki. What was that movie called again? Princess Mononoke. Yeah, that's it. With the spiritual deer or something like that. I don't remember what it's called. Uh-oh. We're about to see something. Oh, jeez. It did not show any mercy. Holy crap. Oh, there's two of them. Holy crap. Now, let's see. Is there anything up in this tree? Okay, I hear something in the distance. Oh, what the hell? I'm kind of scared. I don't know what that is. This is the part of the game where I'm entirely blind. I have no idea what to expect, so... Oh, I hate that noise. That noise is really... Oh, boy. Okay. Whatever, let's just face through it. Let's face it head on. Oh, what? What the f- This is straight out Hayao Miyazaki. What the hell is- What? Oh my- Whoa. You guys want to communicate? Oh, okay, we can. Not with you guys, but holy shit! Oh my god! That thing is big. And that's an understatement. It's the deer god from Princess Mononoke, whatever the hell that thing is called. Oh my god, I'm getting goosebumps. Hold a second. Okay, so... Oh my goodness, okay. Okay, I'm going to go over here first, just to see if there's anything. Okay, there's not. No. What is going on? What the hell? Man, that thing is huge. And that noise is very ominous. Let's hear it again. Yeah, it's like it's growling in pain. Yeah, at least it sounds like that. Shoot, man. That thing is... Oh, it's gorgeous, though. That's the thing, like, it's hor- and oh, shoot. Okay. It's like, it's terrifying, it's enormous, but it's so beautiful, and oh, he ran away. Okay. It's such a beauty to look at, though. Holy crap. It looks like there's... Let me get a good... Oh, geez. The frames. Let me get a good look at it, though. Yeah, it looks like there's trees growing on top of it, so I think that's an implication that I'll have the ability to climb on it eventually, but okay. Oh boy, let's see. So it seems like there are things restraining it. My guess would we have to, and oh my goodness, these guys just crawl out of nowhere. You wanna move? Oh, okay, he's just going back and forth, okay. Well, at least that's settled. So it looks like he's in a bondage, or bondage, he's in a bind, and we had to help him out. We had to, and oh, jeez. Okay, let's just, oh! What? Okay, good. Wait a minute. Wait, I thought he was looking over there. Why did he turn around? Does he turn around? Okay, I guess he just spawned me out of luck. Let's see. Oh boy. Okay. I'm gonna go back. I'm gonna go back. There you go. Let's see. Man, this, I hate the close-up, man. Can we zoom out the camera? Okay, I think that's a little better. Okay. I think there's gonna be some robots over here. Roly-polies, I mean. Yeah, there's one over there. Man, that thing is just so cool. Can I get close? Let's get a first-person shot. Man. Straight up Hayao Miyazaki right there. It really is. Or some other kind of artistic movie that I probably never saw that had a giant deer in it. I'm not too sure. But I don't know. Deers. I mean, if Bambi ever taught me anything, is that deers are mythical beings, and they really show that in Princess Mononoke. I love that movie. That movie was great. And just going through this tunnel, and can I do anything to that? Let's see. No. Oh! I can't hide. Okay. Well, I kind of expected that to happen. Where's it gonna put me? It put me. Where am I? Oh. Okay, I guess I get a better shot of what's going on. Let's see. Okay, there's one roly-poly. There's a flower up there. I can't do anything about it, I'm guessing. I should have done that, but I'm gonna do it. Okay, let's hide. Oh boy. Also, I was about to say. There's a YouTube channel that I'm following right now, called, I can't remember. I think there was a Ghost Toaster or Toaster Ghost. I can't remember their official name, but they're like, it's like a collab of people, and they just do like video games together. But one of their recent games, or at least last month, one of their recent games. Because here's the thing, I'm a fan of horror, and oh my god, get in the stupid thing. Okay, I'm a fan of horror, and okay, Jesus Christ. Okay, just go away. Okay, you know, I'll just talk about it. Anyway, I'm a fan of horror. I'm a fan of horror games. I'm a fan of just, you know, survivals and all that kind of stuff. You know, those kind of games always pique my interest. But here's the thing. I have a certain limit, okay? I have a certain limit when it comes to certain games. I mean, like, I'm okay with toilet humor. Like, toilet humor doesn't really bother me. It's like one of those weird occurrences that, because I feel like everyone makes toilet humor like once in a while. It's like, it's not really like, you don't really hate it or like love it. It's just like one of those instinct, those things that are just kind of like instincts. But they were playing a game, I think it was in January, and it was called like A Dump in the Dark, and based on the name, I don't remember what the premise of the game was, but it's kind of like any other horror simulator, except that it's like, this is what I got from the game. It looks like that you're like somewhat possessed, and the entire game you play as like, I don't know, it's like, it's so weird. It's like you play as like a guy who has like demon diarrhea or something of the sort, and the entire game is that you're shooting, like, you're pretty much shooting fecal matter at different, you're shooting fecal matter at your opponents, at different enemies, and it's like one of the, it's just one of those games where it's like, why do you exist? It is absolutely one of the most disgusting, one of the most absolutely, what the fuck, sorry, I just had to swear there. It is one of the most disturbing games I've ever seen in my entire life, and one of the reasons is because not only is the butt physics, the jiggle of the butt, is very unsettling, but just the whole premise is like you're shooting fecal matter at the enemy, and it's just all, it's like brownish and black. It's just, ugh. It is just, ugh. I cannot, like, I follow them, but those are like, that's like one of those games that I just can't watch. I literally cannot watch. It's just, it is too much. It's too, it's just, oh, I can't even describe it, man. It's just one of those games that you kind of question the person's insanity. Like, it's like, why would anyone make this game? It is, oh, geez. It's just, oh, I mean, if you want to watch it, go on ahead. Head. Okay, that was weird. He kind of just like went in like in a circle. But what I was about to say is that if you want to watch it, go on ahead and watch their video. It's quite interesting, but still, it is just pure. It's just nasty all the way through. It's just, ugh, I cannot watch that game. It's like, it's one of those few horror games where I just cannot play. Listen, I'm more composed. I can chop off a baby's head in a game, and I'd be more composed of that. But watching a man with demon diarrhea, that's just too much. I'm sorry. That's just one of those weird exceptions where it's like, toilet humor is too much for me. I can take a little toilet humor, but when it goes to, pretty much, if you mix toilet humor with horror, that's just absolutely the, no. No, just terrible, terrible. But anyway, at least that's how I feel. I mean, maybe, because I don't get scared too often. Like, when I, like, watch a horror movie or, you know, any type of, like, you know, kind of thriller, I rarely get scared. I rarely do. So, but it's not really being scared. It's more so that it's just really unsanitary. But anyway, and oh boy, let's see, I need a, oh boy, this is a very weird spot. How am I supposed to get past him? Is there some kind of, oh god, he's gonna come back. What am I supposed to do? Oh, jeez. Oh, I think I missed the one over there. I guess I was too caught up in talking about demon diarrhea that I completely forgot that one over there. And, oh, jeez. Oh, jeez. Oh, God. Okay, I cannot. Okay. Can you guys go away, please? Can you go away? Thank you. Okay, so I cannot get past him, so Let's break whoever's in here. Let's see. Who are you? Oh, hey, it's a Bumby. Well, actually, no. That is Bumby's dad. Actually, no, that's more like Bumby's grandfather or something. I don't know. Oh, geez. Oh, wait a minute. Am I supposed to follow him? Oh, geez. Okay, cool. Hey, buddy, do you want some fruit? I'm assuming I'm supposed to give this to him. Am I? Okay. Okay, cool. So, I guess he'll just kind of, like, beat down all the roly-polies. Hey, come on. No, where are you going? Oh, God. Okay, so I have to use the fruit to, lead him. I think. Okay, let's go back over here. Let's see. There we go. Just follow me. No. Just follow me. Follow me. You're about to get revenge for your grandfather. Actually, I have a grandfather. No, that's Bumby's god. That's Bumby's god. Okay, and yay, good. So I'm assuming I was supposed to do that. Let's get that fruit. Let's get it. Cool. And seriously, that thing is humongous. Jesus. Can't wait to see what he looks like at the very top. And bam. Oh. Oh, okay. So we just have to free the flowers and, you know, that'll help him out. Cool. But with that being said, I think I'm going to end off here because, you know, like I said, again, I want to try and keep these videos at least like 20 to 25 minutes long so I don't get too overbeared with, you know, so much. But yeah, and let's just get one more shot. And oh my God, that thing is so beautiful. Man, I don't know why, but for some reason, whenever you're in like a forest setting, deer are like one of the most beautiful creatures to gawk at. They really are. Oh man, I can't wait to ride him. That sounds weird, but you know, that's just me. But anyway, but that being said, I'm gonna end it off here. So, next time on FIA, hopefully we'll free Bumby's god or something. I don't know. They're all related somehow. But yeah, this is Mr. Sure Shot, and I'll see you guys next time. That thing is gorgeous. Oh my goodness.